when you say, when you seen me go, when you seen me go crazy, like, I don't even consider that going crazy. I'm being me. This how I pop it, kid. I'm just telling you. I mean, I ain't really got no, I don't feel no way about how I talk to no another man. You dig what I'm saying? I ain't here to soothe no motherfucking men. I ain't here to tiptoe around no niggas' egos. You dig what I'm saying? You know, you's a man, I'm a man. Shit, we gonna motherfucking, I'm gonna speak to you the way you would speak to me. And shit, we gonna have to have a mutual respect right here.
But I think you set the tone off.
Mm-hmm.
When you had that video with Kevin Hart.
Yeah, 50, yeah, I did that. I did that.
50 responds with the old 1-800 crime.
Yeah,
what
yeah,
was going
yeah,
through
yeah.
your mind? Hey, hold up, Tip. What was going through your mind when you made that commercial? Like, what? I mean, please.
Let me tell you the story. Let me tell you the story. This shit is, hey, listen. So, the shit, I had my case going through the shit, negotiating back and forth, and I told my attorneys one thing. Ain't no cooperation. Cooperation is off the table. Ain't no motherfucker. Ain't no rule 35. You know what I mean? Cooperation off the table. But anything else they talking about, I want to hear. You know what I mean? Ain't no cooperation. Ain't nothing to tell on. Ain't none of that shit. So they came back and was on some shit like, okay, well, we want to use you. We want to use you to help young kids, you know, keep from making the same mistakes as you did. And so on and so forth. And it just kept saying, and work with law enforcement. I said, I ain't working with no goddamn law enforcement now. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'm willing to goddamn go use my testimony and speak to kids and keep them going that, but I ain't working with no law enforcement. And my lawyer was like, listen, it's just the language that they putting in there. Don't worry about it, man. And listen, I tell you what, you're going to go speak to the kids. They'll have some officers there. They, you know, it's security anyway. You don't have to stand with them. You don't have to do that. Just, and then it has something about a commercial in the plea agreement. And I just kept saying, man, nah, I ain't doing no commercial. I ain't doing no goddamn commercial, man. I ain't studying that shit. So I went through the whole process. And mind you, I'm on $3 million bond. You dig what I'm saying? They gave me a downward departure from my sentence, which, and they excused that with the community service and shit that I was doing. So one of the community service mandates was this commercial they wanted me to do. Now, mind you, what they wanted me to do was, they wanted me to stand in front of some police and shit and goddamn talk like, I ain't finna do that. So it got down to the last day before I had to turn in my goddamn, before I had to turn in my all of my shit, my community service, my 1,000 hours that I had to do in order to be eligible for the downward departure. And motherfucker said, well, shit, you still got to do this drop.
I get it. So now,
I did the motherfucking drop. But hey, whoa. I want to say one thing. Uh-huh. Tip has never gave any information to any form of law enforcement to get any man any amount of time for any crime, period. Ever.
Okay, let's go there, right? So now, you know, the room is in the streets. Hold up, Tip. The room is in the streets. Yo, how he get caught with grenade launches and silences and all. I didn't want to go there, but you want to go.
You want to talk about it?
Now, let's talk about it. You.
I'm going to tell you how it happened. I'm going
to
tell you how it happened.
You pushing this conversation. I'm not here to disrespect you.
I don't give a damn, man. Hey, man, I don't feel no way about it because the truth ain't hard to tell. I don't feel no way about this shit.
So
the whole case started, right? I had a security, right? My security, he was telling me, hey, look, we need to upgrade our equipment at the house because I had 24-hour round-the-house security. We need to upgrade our equipment because we were having shit going on in the city where motherfuckers were got there running around with 100-round drones and fully automatics and shit. And, you know, they were running around with handguns. So they kept coming back saying they need to upgrade their equipment. So he'll tell me, shit, man, you need about goddamn $8,000. We need to have a bunch to upgrade the equipment. I give it to him. So he'll go and he'll bring me back shit brand new in the box. I put it in my goddamn, my secret closet and motherfucking, and you know, every time they come on their detail, they grab whatever piece they want to use and then they put it back when they're done. So the motherfucker kept on just asking me for more shit to buy equipment. So finally he say, it's one last thing we need to get. It costs $10,000. I said, all right, bet. I gave him $10,000. Never thought about it again. So now this nigga keep calling me and calling me. Hey, man, I got you. I got something I need to get you. I got something something I need to give you. Got something I need to give you. I need to put it in your hand. I said, man, just take it to the house and give it to one of the guys on duty. You know, now I need to put it in your hands. I got to put it in your hands, especially. I said, man, I'm doing a motherfucking rehearsal for a guy for the BET Award. He said, well, where is that? I said, it's at the Civic Center. He said, good, because I'm right here at the Walgreens. Meet me right here. I said, all right, man, shit. So I pull up. He get in. He's sweating like a motherfucker. Sweating like a motherfucker. And mind you, I told you, I'm used to getting shit in brand new in boxes. That nigga brought me some shit in a motherfucking bag with dust on it and shit. Unzipped it, showed me a dusty, rusty ass motherfucking, talking about this is fully automatic. Then he went to screwing on the silencer, talking about didn't, and no flash, no bang. It came with it different. I say, nigga, this ain't, I ain't asked for this shit, bro. I didn't ask for this shit, bro. This shit, I want this shit brand new in the box. Like, you been getting, I don't want this shit, man. What the fuck wrong with you? All right, so right when I said I ain't want it, boom, they bust. I never took possession. He still had possession. He was still in the car. You dig what I'm saying? I had more guns in the car with me, but guess who they was registered to? Him. He bought them motherfuckers. They were his, too. Now, what they did was, though, they gave them probable cause to come search my house, so they went in the closet and got my guns out the closet and blah, 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 woo, woo. Okay. So now all the guns in the car, I got beat. And my argument was, well, check this out, bro. If the guns in the car, if you never would have charged me with this, you wouldn't have had no probable cause to get to the house, so you got to kick that out, too. And my lawyer said, okay, look, we can make that argument. But I had a biometric scan with a fingerprint where every time I go in, you motherfucking, I put my fingerprint on there. So it recorded when I opened it with my fingerprint and when other people opened it with the code. So they're like, well, shit, bro, you can't goddamn, you can't get away from you had constructive possession of these firearms. You might be able to argue that they didn't have a probable cause, but why would you go through that if you got a year and a day plea right here? Why would you go to trial and risk 30 years if you lose? If you lose, it'll be, if they charge you for every gun, it can easily be 30 years if you don't beat the motherfucking probable cause. So I said, shit, fuck it. I'll take the motherfucking year and a day. Shit.
I take a year and a day too.
So that's what motherfucker. So when motherfucker be talking about why in the fuck did I get off with all that shit? Cause the case was weak. The case was weak. I still think every day I wake up thinking I still could have beat him. But I'm glad I got damn shit. I did what the fuck I had to do. So ain't no ratting in that, nigga, at all. And nigga, ain't nobody finna sit and watch no motherfucking commercial and say, well, I wasn't gonna snitch, but since I seen this commercial now, I'ma go ahead and tell it. Nigga, if you gonna tell, nigga, you gonna tell. Nigga, fuck the people with commercial or no commercial. And if you're a civilian, because this is what I was speaking to civilians, nigga. Nigga, if you're a civilian, nigga, and you see a motherfucker breaking in a motherfucking old lady house, that old lady that got raped and beat up and robbed or a kid missing or some shit like that, nigga, if you ain't finna go out and handle that shit yourself, nigga. Nigga, you gonna have to goddamn get some authorities involved at some point in time, bro. Nigga, that's just a motherfucking man. I don't know what the fuck you talking about, nigga. And nigga think, nigga, I'm a rat, nigga. Knock my nose off when you see me, nigga. Nigga, shoot me in the head, nigga, if you think I'm a motherfucking rat.
So, it's safe to say you're not feeling rats. You don't like rats. You don't like snitching. You don't like...
My nigga, let me tell you something, bro. I'm raised by a motherfucking family full of motherfucking hustlers. Nigga, my uncle did a 10, nigga. My uncle did a 10 because they were looking for my other uncle, and my uncle said, well, shit, I'm who you got. My uncle did a 10. Nigga, my daddy, nigga, goddamn, ran numbers and made their money in Harlem up on the hill, nigga, selling heroin and doing their thing, nigga. I can't go to Thanksgiving dinner being no motherfucker. I can't go back to motherfucking... I can't go home. Nigga, I can't motherfucking... Nigga, are you serious? Got me fucked up, all of them. And nigga ain't fixed their mouth to say it. Nigga, I see you saying in my face, nigga, I'm going to your shit. Okay, T.I. What else you want to talk about, bro? What else you want to talk about?